I read this really interesting thing when I was researching for these episodes about how salmon is the one item that really connects all of Alaska. It's so integral in the ecosystem, the economy, heritage, and tradition.
Salmon is the base of all of our subsistence. It's such a versatile fish, there's so many things you can do with it. It all starts from there.
My adventure into Alaska salmon starts in the tiny town of Port Lions on Kodiak Island. Join me, Kelly, as I attempt to hunt, forage, and farm my way across the globe in search of the best ingredients our planet has to offer. This is Original Fare.
So we flew into Anchorage late last night, got up early, took another plane to Kodiak Island, and now we're on a boat to get to another part of Kodiak Island, which is Port Lions. How was your guys' boat ride? So happy to be on the boat.
Well, good.
Alright, you're Sarah?
Yes.
Kelly, yeah, so nice to finally meet you.
We're excited.
Well, we're excited.
My guides are the subsistence and commercial fishing Skvortsov family, who were born and raised in this tiny village of about 194 souls.
We do fish like, it reminds me of Forrest Gump, where Bubba's talking about shrimp. That's like our fish life in the summer.
It is. No joke.
To know what these long sticks are for.
These, just to set the racks on so you get good airflow when you dry them out, because you have to dry.
Who taught you gals how to cook? Yourselves?
Well, we just grew up in a small town with no restaurants or, and we just grew up cooking. My dad's a great cook, mom's a great cook. Then as we got older, I think we got into the traditional foods a lot more.
Yeah.
And, you know, making the smoked salmon and learning how to preserve our foods and put foods up for winter because our dad's not going to be around forever.
Self-reliant women.
Well, my dad got stuck with three girls. So. Poor guy.
So this is one of many variations of smoked salmon?
This is the hot smoked.
Show me how this is done.
So there's three steps in the hot smoke, which is going to be cutting the fish and putting it into the brine.
It's real basic. It's just water, brown sugar, soy sauce, lemon juice, tender quick, and then I added some sriracha and barbecue sauce in this batch.
Will this method and process work with any type of salmon you catch?
Mm-hmm. You just want to try to make sure the pieces are cut pretty uniform so that way they get done around the same time. And then so the second step is going to be putting them onto the racks. You just kind of start placing them on there.
Skin side down.
Skin side down.
Ooh, look at how pretty this is.
And then we're gonna put the fan on them and let them air dry for about what?
About 8 to 10 hours.
Yeah.
And that's just to make sure the brine's sealed in good and you don't want it too wet when you put it into the hot smoker, so it gives it a good texture. And then once it's drying too, we'll glaze it with some honey and barbecue sauce, maybe some red pepper flakes. Then it'll go into the smoker, probably with a cook time of about 2.5 hours and a smoke time of 3 hours.
The older sister of three, Sarah's expertise lies in the kitchen. Lisa, however, has taken over her father's set net site, and that's where our real adventure begins.
Be safe out there.
It'd be a little choppy.
Idiot.
Thank you.
Lift it up?
Yeah, see, these are the guys that we're looking for.
Oh my god. Wow.
This is Cook Inlet Red.
Cook Inlet Red. Oh yeah, that's the cookies.
These are our money fish.
Morning, afternoon, and night. Lisa is checking her set net.
Lisa, do you ever get tired of this?
Yeah, definitely do when there's no fish.
Yeah.
It gets very tiring, mentally draining.
Yeah.
Putting in all this work and getting nothing out of it, really. But on the good days, when there is fish, you won't see me complaining or whining. That's for sure.
This is not a job for the timid. I was slaying fish left and right. So much so that the sensation of gills ripping was haunting my fingers like a ghostly imprint. But this isn't recreational sport. This is survival. Remember, there are no grocery stores or restaurants connected to this town by land.
Humpy.
Humpy. Okay, are those pretty decent?
Yeah, they're really good eating, but...
not so much for the money. There's a moral difference between hunting and fishing? Let us know in the comment section. And tune in next week as our adventure in Alaskan salmon continues. For more adventures in food, subscribe to our channel.